all and welcome back. So in this video, let's discuss about order sorting inventory management in community. So order inventory management is a resourceful module that can be utilized by any business organization irrespective of its size. The final results of a company are the product movement and storage which takes place in the inventory of a company. So order software recognizes the need of an effective, efficient and reliable inventory management system which paves the way for the development of inventory model and its additional attributes. So this module, order inventory module, is interconnected with various aspects of a company operation such as sales, purchase, point of sale, manufacturing, repairs and many more aspects in the company operation of order. So this allows order platform to have an efficient operation and would improve the productivity and profitability of company. So let's go through all the features available in our inventory management module. So after installing inventory from Odo App Store, you can find that here. So when you open inventory, you can see here we have an inventory overview that consists of different operation types. So you can see operation can be received, type can be received, internal transfer, delivery orders, manufacturing, point of sale orders, dropship. So the operation types shown here depends upon the settings that you have done on your warehouse. So when you come under configuration, you can find your warehouse, and inside the warehouse, you can set the route. That is, you can set the route for incoming shipment and outgoing shipment. So the operation type shown on the dashboard, that is inventory overview, depends upon this route. So if I set third option, that is three step as for our outgoing shipment as route, and if you save that and if you come back to overview, okay, so here we can see some additional operation types added, that is pick and pack. This is pick and pack operations that need to be done when you are delivering products to customers in three-step route. Okay. Then here for each operation type, we can see the number of operations to be processed, transfers to be processed. Then the late, and if there are any back orders, you can see. Then if there are any waiting operations or transfers to be done, you can see that also. So when you click on this, you can view all the waiting transfers. So you can see the waiting delivery orders. And you can see number of orders, that is number of transfers to be processed. So you can see we have 7 receipts need to be done. So just click on the transfer, you can validate from here. So you can validate the receipt from here. You can click apply. Okay, now when you come back to overview, you can see there are only 6 to process. In the same way, you can see the number of receipts, that is late receipts. You can see the date. Okay, then if you click on these 3 dots, you can see a lot of options. Let us again set a color for your operation type. You can see the color here, and you can view all receipts, ready receipts, waiting receipts. Then you can create immediate transfer, then plan transfer, and you can also make, that is, you can configure your operation types. So here we can set the name of the operation type, code for the operation type. Then we can set the type of operation. So basically we have 4 type of operation. It can be receipt, delivery, internal transfer, or manufacturing. and we can set company, a lot of details, location and traceability details. So we have done a separate video on how to create and manage operation types in Odoo 14. So please check that. So these are the things coming in inventory overview, and you can filter this by adding custom filtrations. Then we can group this operation types by type of operation and warehouse. So before going to other options from here, let's go to configuration settings and configure our inventory module. Let us see. Let's go through some settings. Okay, so if you want to pack your items as boxes or parcels and track them, that is track those packages, you can do that by enabling this option packages. So you can create packages, so multiple items, different items can be put together inside a parcel or a box and it can be delivered to customers. Okay, and you can see an option inside, that is when you are validating the delivery, you can see an option put in pack. So you can use that option to put items in a pack and deliver to customers. So we have done a video on product packaging in Odoo 14 community, where we have discussed about packages, packagings and delivery packages in Odoo 14 community. So please go through that video to know more about it. Then we have batch pickings. So this option can be used in order to process transfers as a batch per worker. So we can group multiple transfers together, having the same operation type together, and we can process them together. Like if you want to perform multiple delivery orders, you can group them together like as a batch and can validate it together. So this enables option batch picking. So orders can be done in a single click. So this reduces transportation costs and other expenses comparatively. Then Odoo also allows us to you to set warning messages and alerts on customers and vendor or products. So this prevents from purchasing a product from vendor or selling a product to customer, or we can also set blocking or warning messages on product. So warning, this option displays a warning message during process but allows user to continue, but blocking message displays a warning message but the user cannot continue the process further. So you can set this on products or partners. Then we can set the picking policy, that is when to start shipping. So shipping can be done when all products are available, that is all products are available at once, or we can deliver, that is we can transfer products as soon as available with back orders. And the remaining can be delivered later. Okay, then here we have an option for reserving sold products. So when to reserve the sold products, it can be done immediately after sale order is confirmed, or manually, or based on automatic scheduler. Then we have an option in order to scan products by using barcode scanner, but this option is only available in enterprise, and you can just click on this and upgrade and purchase this application module from Odoo pricing. Okay, then here we have an option, some details, settings related to shipping. So we can send automatic confirmation email when delivery orders are done by enabling this option. Then we have SMS confirmation option that sends an automatic confirmation SMS when delivery orders are done. And we can set an SMS template here. But for this, we have to acquire some credits. Then it is also possible to add that is request for signature on your delivery orders. So the signature is really helpful, that makes approval and signing process simple. So it is a quick method. So we can sign and approve documents using this option. Then here we can find an option to compute shipping cost using delivery methods. So you can create new delivery methods and use it for shipping products. And we can set calculate shipping cost based on different, that is using different ways. Then we have shipping connectors. So we have different shipping providers here. So these are only available in Enterprise Edition, and you can purchase it from Order Pricing. So you can use this shipping connectors inside our shipping methods, that is delivery methods. Then we can set options, some features related to products, that is we can configure product variants. So this is another terminology of Odoo inventory operations, which allows users to classify products available. So we can create different variations of a product and can sell those variations to customers. So products can be classified into customizable variants, and multi-level variants can also be classified. Then we can also create unit of measures. So we can sell and purchase product in different units of measure. Then you can see an option that is product packaging. So we can create product packaging, that is for a particular product, we can create packagings and add packagings from the product configuration form. Then we can set details related to traceability of product. So we can track products using slots or serial numbers when you enable this option. So we can trace a product starting from, that is purchasing the product to delivery of products to customers. Then we can also set expiration dates on lots and serial numbers. Then we can display lots and serial numbers on delivery slips and invoices. Then here we have an option that is we can set an honor on stored products using consignment technique. So consignment means giving some products or goods to a consignee or a third party for selling while retaining the ownership and paying a charge to the seller. So mainly this happens in retail shops in a mutual agreement or a contract between two parties, owner and consignee. So here the consignee is responsible for selling the products, though he is not the owner of the product. So in return of the sale, he gets paid. So this is used to check the market value of products in products. Okay, so for this also we have done a separate video. Then we can set details related to valuation of products. Here we can mark, that is enable landed cost, so that we can add additional cost, that is transportation, insurance fee. So these charges can be added to products cost. So just enable this option, and you can also set a default journal for managing landed cost. Then we can also configure, that is create custom locations and use pre-configured locations by using enable this storage location feature. So we can configure locations, that is we can create virtual locations, internal locations, inventory loads locations. So storage locations are nothing but the locations where we store our products. So it can be physical or virtual. Then we can make use of the option multi-step routes in order to create and manage the path through which a product moves. So you can make use of some pre-configured routes. That is, we have some pre-configured routes in our Odoo, and we can also create custom routes, and we can manage the movement of products. So we can set warehouse routes. Then we can make use of some advanced scheduling options in order to schedule set security lead time for sales and purchase. So in the case of sales, Security lead time corresponds to the backup days to ensure you are able to deliver the products in time. So this purpose, the purpose is to ready shipping earlier in order to arrive on time. So we can set some days earlier to avoid delays. Then security lead time for purchase. So it follows the same logic as the one for sales. That is, orders are scheduled many days earlier to cope up with unexpected vendor delays. And we can also set the days to purchase, that is total days needed to confirm a purchase order and when it should be validated. Okay, so you can enable required options from here. And save the settings. Okay, so after setting inventory, here we can configure something, like you can configure warehouses. So we have opened warehouses before. So we can create multiple warehouses and we can set a short name for a warehouse, we can set address, then some details related to configuration of warehouse like incoming and outgoing shipments. So, in case of both incoming and outgoing shipments, we have different rules. We can set different rules. That is, we can receive products directly in our stock, or we can use two-step in order to receive products in input location and then to stock, or we can receive products in input location and then move to a quality checking area, quality checking location, and after the quality is checked, we can receive the products in our stock. Then we can use outgoing shipments, that is, we can set route for delivering products to customers. That is, we can deliver goods directly to customers, or we can send goods to an output location and then to customer's location. Or we can use the three step in order to pack goods. That is, first we have to pack goods, then send to output location, and after that only deliver to customers. So you can set the routes here for your warehouse. Then we can find, set some details related to resupply of products. We can resupply subcontractors with components, manufactured resupply. So when products are manufactured, they can be manufactured in this warehouse. Then we can also set route for your manufacturing, that is, we can directly manufacture product, or we can pick components and then manufacture, or we can pick components, manufacture and then store products. So when you enable third option, we will have an additional operation type in our inventory overview, that is storage. So when you save this warehouse and when you go to overview, here we can see an additional operation type, that is to store finished product. So when you just open that operation type, you can see the operation. That is, after manufacturing, we can move the product from production location to stock. And we can also view all the routes for a warehouse. So when you click on this routes, you can see all the routes related to this warehouse. So we have manufacturing, buy, receiving, delivery, then resupplying and all. Okay. So this is how we configure warehouses. So warehouses are the actual building places in which your items are stocked. So we can also set up multiple warehouses and create moves between warehouses. So we can create new warehouse and we can set a short name for the warehouse, UH2. So this is nothing but to represent the warehouse. So when you are creating locations and all, we can represent the location, that is to which warehouse the location belongs to. So for that we can make use of the short code. Okay, so you can see stock for warehouse WH2 and you can see WH stock. And here we can also find an option in order to resupply from a different warehouse when products are not available in current warehouse. Okay, then after configuring warehouses, we can create locations. So here we can see some pre-configured location like subcontracting location. So you can see pre-production, post-production, stock, shelf 1, shelf 2. So location is nothing but it can be referred to as a specific place inside our own warehouse or external warehouse that we do not own. So it resembles a sub-location in warehouse like shelf, floor and all. So one can create and configure many locations as they need under a single warehouse. And we have different types of locations, like we have physical location, partner location, virtual location. So physical locations are defined for internal locations within a warehouse for which we are the owner. So for physical location, actual inventory management is done. Then we have partner locations. That is used to show the warehouse of a customer or vendor in Odoo. So partner locations are actually virtual locations. So they work similar to physical locations, but the individuals are the owner of the warehouse. So one can place products when they are physically not in inventory. So we can close this internal as these locations are filtered by default by internal locations or physical locations. So we can close this and view all the available locations. So here we can see our partner locations for customers and vendors. And we have other virtual locations, which is helpful when an individual needs to place those items out of stock or when an individual consider those items that are in route to the distribution center. Okay, can create new location from here. You can add location type. And we can set a partner parent location. So for location, we have an option, that is we can manage hierarchy. So we have a hierarchical structure for location, that is parent child structure. So here we can set physical location as a parent. Then we can add some additional information like location type. So we have internal location, customer location, vendor location, view. So view is used just to it is just to represent. That is represent the warehouse. It is a base name, act as a base name, and is also a virtual location. So the hierarchical structures of a warehouse are built upon using this view. And we can see inventory loads, production location, where production is done, transit location, when you are transferring products from one warehouse to other warehouse or from one company to other company. So here I'm creating a physical location in the internal location naming shelf 3 where actual inventory management is done. Then if you are creating a scrap location, that is to manage damaged products, you can mark it as scrap. Then if you're creating a return location, you can mark it as return location. And you can also set a removal strategy for your location when the product needs to be removed from the stock. It can be done by using the strategy first in, first out. So first in products are moved first, then last in, first out. Last purchase products or last in products are moved out first. Then we can also remove products that expires first using the third option. And after creating location and after making some transfers, we can view the current stock of a location, the total products in location. So we can filter this by inventory date and all.
So our new physical location is created, shelf 3. So you can see that here. Okay, so this is how we configure, create locations. Then we have routes and rules. So routes are the path through which a product moves, and we can create rules by adding rules. So rules means we have procurement and push rules. So procurement means whenever there is a need in location, only the transfer will be done, products will be moved. Then we have push rule, that is whenever product arrives in a location, it will be moved to a different location. So for routes and rules in Odoo 14 community, we have done a separate video. So you can check that to know more about it. And we have some pre-configured routes in our Odoo, like resupplying, drop shipping, buy, manufacture, receiving, for delivering products. You can see different routes. And when you open that, you can see some details related to the route, like we can see the company of the route, where the route can be applied. So we can apply this route specifically on a product, product category, or to a warehouse. So we can set this route to multiple warehouse. Then we can also select a route from sale order line while you are delivering. That is, while a product is ordered, there also we can select a route. So inside a route, we can also add multiple rules that can be push or pull rules, and you can see the source and destination location of the route. Okay, then you can also view all the rules. So you can see the source, see the action performed in each rule, the route in which the rule is used, the you can see source, destination location and all. Then we can configure operation types that we have seen. From overview itself, we can configure operation type, and from here also we can create new operation type or use existing one, that is update existing one. So it is not recommended to update the existing operation type. Then we can create put away rules. So good warehouse implementation takes care that products automatically move to their appropriate destination location. To make this process easier, Odoo uses put away rules. So it is a process of taking of receiving shipments and directly putting them into most appropriate location. For example, if a warehouse contains some volatile substances, it is important to make sure that certain products are not stored close to each other because of a potential chemical reaction. So to avoid that, we have to move them to a different location. So you can create rules, set the product category, then we can set the source location, and we can move to a different location. So for this also we have done a separate video, you can check that. Then we can configure product category, that is product groups. So we have different groups already. We have some different groups like consumable products, expense products, saleable products. So when you just open it, you can see the details. And then for this product category also, we can maintain a hierarchical structure. Then we can set routes, forced removal strategy for the product category. Then we can set costing method, inventory valuation method, then account properties. Then if you are posting the entries automatically, you have to set account stock properties including valuation account, input output account, journal and all. Then we can also see the total products coming under this product category. Then we can set put away rules, see the put away rules for each category. Then we can configure attributes and set for your products and create and manage product values. So here we can see of option to configure products, create products. So when you open that, you can see all the products. You can filter this by different type of products. Then you can filter by can be sold, purchase, subcontracted. Group these products by type and category. And you can set variants inside the product form. That is, after configuring attributes, you can set attributes and their values. So instantly and dynamically, you can create variants and you can view all the variants from here. Okay, so for managing product variants also we have done a separate video. Then we can create product packagings. So directly from here we can create packagings, or from the product form we can create packaging. Suppose I want to create pack of 10 quantity of a product. So here we can select the product. So if I want whiteboard pen package containing 10 quantities. So here we can set the quantity, and we can set, if you want to set barcode, you can set from here. And if you want to make this package available to a particular company, you can set that company here and can save this. Okay, so we can purchase products as package. Then we can create reordering rules. So by triggering reordering rules, we can maintain a minimum stock. So we can create, we can trigger reordering rule automatically or manually. So when a product's quantity goes below a minimum quantity set inside the rule, an RFQ or a manufacturing order can be triggered. That is, replenishment can be done and refill the stock by a maximum quantity. So the refilling is done depending upon the multiple quantity that you set here. So it can also go be above the maximum quantity. So replenishment can be done from a product form, or by coming under operations, you can find a new menu in order to create replenishment. So you can find the replenishment lines here and can manually create new one from here, adding the product. You can set the location, see the location, set on hand forecast, see the on hand forecast, and we can set a preferred route. Then we can set a minimum maximum quantity and the total quantities to be ordered. Then we can order the product once or automatically can be ordered. Then we can also set reminders. And if you have created an automatic reordering rule, that is a rule that is triggered automatically, then it will be done daily, or we can use the option run scheduler to run that reordering rule manually from here. So stock will be reserved for operations waiting for availability. Then we can configure unit of measure category, create unit of measure category and create unit of measures. So we can sell and purchase products in different units of measure, and we can set the default unit of measure inside the product form. Then unit of default purchase unit of measure also on the product form. So we have done a separate video on how to manage unit of measure, how to create unit of measure in Odoo 14 community. So please check that video. Then we can also create shipping methods and calculate shipping cost of products using formulas, or we can also set fixed price for products, fixed shipping price for products. So you can make use of this delivery methods on your sale orders, and not only on sale orders but also on your e-commerce shop. So it allows you to manage the transport price and destination, and you can also even integrate with external shippers to compute real price and packages. So for shipping methods in Odoo 14 community also we have done a separate video. And then we can create delivery packages. So depending on the volume, weight or weight of your products, you have the possibility to deliver your products in different packages. So you can create different packages, delivery packages here. Can set the height in meter. Can set weight, maximum weight of this package, then a barcode for this delivery package, then you can set a package code and can save this delivery package and set this delivery package on your product package. So here we can see product packages, that is, we can group multiple products and pack it together and deliver to customers. So it is similar to a kit, that is multiple products in a single package, in a parcel or a box. So here we can set delivery package. Okay, so you can select our container and you can save it. So we have created a pack here, and when you are delivering products to customers, you can put those products to this package. So for delivery package, packages and packaging, we all together, we have done a single video, that is product packaging in Odoo 14 community. So please check that video. Okay. So this is how the packaging is done. Then we can, if you want to create operations, that is transfers directly, you can just click on transfers and you can view all the transfers. This includes delivery receipts, internal transfers and all. So you can create new transfer by clicking create button and can provide the contact from here. Then set the operation type. So if you are selecting delivery orders, you can see the source location is set as stock as default. So if you want to change that, you can change from here. And you can add the product. You can add multiple products and set the quantity, demand, set schedule date, source document, and you can save the transfer. And if you found any damage, you can mark scrap and you can move to scrap location. Okay, so if it is done, you can mark as to do and check availability of the product and validate the transfer. So you can apply. So you can see transfer is done, and you can also sign the document from here. Okay, so after creating transfer, if you want to view the transfer, you can filter it by done transfer. So here we can view our transfer. Okay. Then here we can see replenishment that we have seen before. Then batch transfer, as we have enabled batch picking from configuration settings, we can group transfers together and validate it together. So here we can see one batch transfer in progress. We have added three transfers here. So from here we can validate and process the transfer together. Okay, so by default it is filtered by draft or progress batch transfer. If you close this, you can see all the batch transfers. So here we can see one done batch transfer. Then we can adjust inventory using inventory adjustment. So this is the most important feature in inventory management. The stocks should be updated and be in specific location to be handy upon orders. Company officials should also have a track of record of movement of products out of inventory, towards inventory and within inventory. Since many companies perform all operations from sale of the product, use product while manufacturing, sell manufactured product, and also at instance providing complimentary gifts as certain products, etc., the company officials should have a track record indicating all the movements and number of products being moved. So there may be instances in a company in which certain adjustments should be made based on physical stocks available in a company. So those adjustments should reflect on record of inventory. So it allows users to make adjustment based on physical stock availability. So you can create adjustment and you can start inventory by setting default stock as zero or a default as stock on hand. And after adding the products, setting the counted, that is real quantity that you have found, you can add update the counted and then validate the inventory from here. So after validating the inventory, when you check the product, you can see that change. We can, and it's also possible to print the count sheet. Then we have an option to mark, that is move damaged products to scrap location. So you can create scrap orders from here, or making delivery order, or purchasing, that is receiving products, you can mark products as damaged. Then we can create landed cost, that is we can add additional cost that can be shipping charge, insurance fee. So these fees, these costs can be added with the purchase price of the products and it can be updated. So for landed cost, Node 14 community also we have done a separate video. Please check that. Then you have seen run schedule option to schedule, run the scheduler manually. That is, we can trigger reordering rules and all. Okay, then okay, we have seen products, product variants and packages. Then we can also create lots and serial numbers in order to track products movement. So we can create lots and identify or track products as group. And we can also trace a product by providing a unique serial number. So for each quantity, we have to provide a unique serial number. And when you're creating lottery serial number or tracking product, it is also possible to set expiration dates. So if you have enabled expiration date on configuration settings, and also if you have enabled it in the product, you can create expiration dates. That is removal date, expiration date, best before date and all for your lottery serial number. Okay, so for that also we have done a separate video, please check that. And then here we have different reporting, that is first we have inventory report. So we can view the stock on hand of products, the total quantity available on hand available, and the total value of each product. Then we can also view the removal date of the products. And if you want to view the stock on hand on a particular date, we can just click on inventory at date and we can add the date and confirm and view the stock at that date. Then here we have forecasted inventory. So this forecasted inventory report gives you the forecasted stock of products. So from here we can select quantity or count of products and view the forecasted inventory at different dates. And from here we can group, filter. So if you want to view forecasted receipts or deliveries, you can just choose from here. So this inventory reports of order platform will provide information on all inventory products available. So product moves and financial aspects and many more. And this report can be viewed in list view, then pivot view and graph view. So pivot view, as depicted below, will provide an analytical data which can be exported to other mediums through Excel file. And filtering as well as group by functionalities allows user to measure the report operation based on company perspectives. So we can see the stock on hand of each product, the total available quantity, on hand quantity and value, and it can be filtered by different options. You can see different grouping options also, and you can also view the inventory of a product of products, that is at a particular date. And then here we have forecasted inventory report. So it is another advanced feature and based on forecasting capabilities, which will allow user to determine and predict the product operations. So Odoo also generates forecasting reports, which will be based on the various forecasting operations conducted in inventory, sales, purchase, and manufacturing operations of company. So say for this forecasted inventory report also, we have filtering, sorting options and grouping options. So we can also filter this by forecasted receipts, deliveries. Then we have inventory valuation report. So this report allows us users to view the stock values, that is to conduct the various inventory valuation of company warehouses and inventory operations. And in addition to that, platform allows user to generate valuation report for the reference and recording purpose for the future, as well as percentage in company's operations. So we can view the product's values at values. So here for this 4-person desk, you can see the total value here. And we can also view the stock valuation report at a particular date. Then we have product moves. So this is used to analyze and record the product movement operations, not only once which are completed, but also the initiated ones. So by default, it is filtered by done product moves and it is grouped by product. So you can see for each product the movement done. So here for large cabinet, you can see large cabinet for 500 quantities moved from inventory adjustment location, that is virtual location, to stock. 100 quantity moved from stock to part customer location. 50 from stock to customer location. So this reporting is one of the main functionalities, main features of Odoo platform. So various reports can be generated based on default as well as customizable sorting functionalities available in each reporting functions. So that's all about inventory management in Odoo 14, and please don't forget to check our description box. There we have provided related videos for this module. And if you have any doubts regarding this video or related topics, please add your comments below. Thank you.